Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So here I am back with another informative video on dentistry in Dubai. So today we have Dr. Disha on our channel, and ma'am has done her BDS from India and right now she is practicing in Dubai. The way ma'am has grown into the field of dentistry is extremely inspiring for me, and I'm sure it will be for you all as well. So let's have a look at Dr. Disha's journey in the field of dentistry. Ma'am is currently practicing at Clover Dental Center, Dubai. And the list of certificates and awards and achievements won by Dr. Disha is, guys, the list is too long. Just have a look by yourself. So I would request you all to watch this video till the end and get the maximum out of this. So I have asked all your frequently asked questions regarding dentistry in Dubai to ma'am, and ma'am have answered it all. So please do watch the video till the end and let us know in the comment section below that how you found this Before video. We dive quickly into this video, if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, then please do subscribe it now, because I make videos on dentistry and which will be most beneficial to you all. Good evening, ma'am. Welcome to my channel.
Hello, Hilary. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Hilary, for such a wonderful introduction. And greetings to one and all. Hope everyone is safe and sound in India. My really heartfelt prayers for each and everyone back in India. And thank you for having me. Please.
My pleasure, ma'am.
So I am Dr. Disha. I'm working as a GP dentist with over 10 years of experience, mostly in clinical endodontics and cosmetic dentistry.
Before a few months, I did a video on dentistry in UAE after doing BDS or MDS in India. So that video is very much liked by my viewers, and still they have queries. So I thought, like, as you yourself is practicing there in Dubai, so who could be a better person than you to solve their queries? So, yes. Ma'am, first, we all would like to know your story, that after doing BDS here in India, you did multiple of courses and then you chose Dubai. So why?
First reason to choose Dubai, it was my personal reason. I got married and my husband got job here. That's the main reason I came down here. But yes, before that, I did my research completely that whether I'm able to work there or not. So most important is Dubai is very close to India, okay? And for a dental practice, the most important thing is you don't have to study further. Like, you don't have to go to college again. Like back in US or Canada or any other countries, if you're planning, there is a chance that you might have to go for studies like DDS you have to go. But in Dubai, it's really pretty easy. You just have to give one exam. And if you are lucky, then you are getting job. And then, yes, then you can start your work. It's like simple. When we say it's really easy, but there are definitely jobs are there. Oh. But yes, life is okay here. Yeah.
Okay. So, ma'am, which emirate is the best to practice?
We can't say like this what is best to practice, because again, it depends on person to person. Basically, if we are counting as an Indian, okay, so Abu Dhabi, as you all are aware already, you must have watched Hilary's last video. She already spoke about different emirates. So you are aware that 7 emirates are there in Dubai. So basically, if any Indian is coming, they are practicing mostly in Abu Dhabi, Dubai, and Sharjah. These three are really nice places, nice emirates where you can work. And most important is, wherever you get the job, just take it. Even it is Abu Dhabi, even it is Dubai or Sharjah, I think all the three are really good. Dubai is really because of the cosmopolitan life. Everyone wants to come down here. So I feel Dubai is really good for a practice.
All right, ma'am. And ma'am, when someone wants to, yes, you know, start their practice or want to come to Dubai, so they have to search for jobs. So what are, can you provide some sources, or like how you find it? What are there different platforms or different Facebook pages or something from where they can get some contacts, or like what is the process?
There are multiple platforms like Indeed, Gulf Naukri Gulf. These platforms are there. Even Dubizzle. These platforms are there which are providing all the information about the jobs. Okay, so I feel these platforms are the best one if you want to go ahead for the, if you are searching for any job. And most important, before COVID, what we were saying to, like, I was also getting so many queries regarding jobs and all. But the thing is, the best is to come down here, search around. You have to speak to every clinic, facility, hospitals, and then definitely you will get a job. But the best way is to come down here and then search a job. It was like, I'm talking about pre-COVID era, but right now things are not that easy. So I will suggest you to search for each and every clinic, check their websites, just drop your CV there and mail them. That's the best way to search. Yes. Okay.
And ma'am, after BDS, how many years of experience is required?
Okay. See, there are two things. If a person wants to work as a general dentist, means as a BDS only, they need minimum of 2 years experience post internship. It means total of 3 years, including internship. Okay. So 1 year internship and 2 years post that. So as a GP, yes, definitely you can work. And for a specialist, if you want to work as an MDS, then you need 3 years post MDS experience.
Okay, okay, fine. And yes. Ma'am, what is the pay scale for BDS and MDS over there? Can you give us a range?
That's something very tricky. Very, very tricky question. See, I don't want to quote any exact amount. It all depends on different Emirates. First of all, which area you are working, which facility you are working, whether you are working in a big hospital or you're working in a small clinic or a polyclinic. And it is most important is to upgrade yourself with different skills. Okay. So sign up for, always sign up for better offers rather than worthless offers. I will just say it. But still, if you are asking me a range, I can just say starting, it would be 1 lakh of Indian rupees.
Okay.
To, it can go up. It can go up till 5 lakh also.
Starts from 1 lakh.
That's it.
Okay, okay.
Starts from 1 lakh. But nowadays, what is happening? I'm just telling you the current scenario, what we are seeing around, what other new people are coming down, new doctors are coming down. So what we are hearing is nowadays salaries are very less. Salary jobs are really less. Now doctors, dentists are going for commission basis job.
Okay.
That's the thing. So in commission, there is no fixed salary. It depends on how many patients you are getting. According to it, you will get a job. You will get salary.
Paid. Okay. Ma'am, can you brief us something about VET tech system?
Okay. See, if you are just asking me about the dental thing, there is not much difference with the VET. Anyways, VET here is only 5%. If you compare with India GST, it is 18%. So yes, there is not much difference. And it's from 2 years only. They have started from 2018. They have started this VET system. And in dental practice or any medical practice, it is not included. Means it is exempted. That's it.
Okay.
Dental practice.
Okay.
So even if you are going out for any dinner or something, if you are going for any place, like any activities, there is a little bit difference of few dirhams. Otherwise, nothing.
Mm-hmm. All right. The most difficulty which most of the students are facing is how to get hired and what extra skills or experience is required.
So, what extra skills? I just want to say, you whatever you are doing there, like the 2 years after post BDS, you have to indulge yourself in a very good clinical practice. Try to work where you are getting more patients. Along with that, I will suggest you to make a portfolio, to make a file, and just try to add all your cases, whatever you are doing. Okay. Along with that, what are the basic skills you should know is the rotary endodontics. You should start, like, I know that in colleges, nobody is teaching this rotary endodontics.
Yes,
maybe
yes.
In internship, if you are in a government hospital or something, you are getting chance. But in the private sector, there are very less patients already. So I suggest you to first do a good rotary endodontics course. Secondly, a cosmetic course, cosmetic dentistry, which is really very useful in case of if you are working in a Dubai, people, they want a cosmetic rehabilitation. They will come down for veneers. They will come down for full mouth rehabilitation. So you should be aware about these basic skills. So first is endo. Second is cosmetic. You can go for any veneer schools or any good restorative dentistry course. Third, I will suggest you for a good oral surgery skill for the extraction. At least if you can go through these three basic, your chances of getting hired is really good.
Okay. So, ma'am, someone has done BDS and they have also done MBA in health management or something. So what are the scopes for them in Dubai?
See, definitely then it depends on that person. If they want to go only towards practice, or they want to go only towards the MBA side, market management side. Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you are coming, if you still want to do a clinical practice, then there is no role of MPH. Mm-hmm. Until unless if you are working in a new clinic or something. Okay. Mm-hmm. And if you want to go for a management side, definitely there are multiple clinics are opening here, multiple hospitals are opening here. So I feel for hospital management, it's really good. It's a good platform, Dubai.
Okay.
And when you want to practice in Dubai, where the people come from all around the world, I'm talking about here, people live from Australia, they are coming from Europe, they are coming from US. I'm talking about everywhere, China, everywhere they are coming. So you have to be a little bit extra. You should know a little bit extra so that you can treat them accordingly, right? Mm-hmm. That's the thing. They want all the skills. There are so many things you have to take care of when you're working in Dubai.
Okay. So, ma'am, so far, how is your experience of practicing dentistry over there?
So, yeah, working in Dubai is really good. We maintain high-class hygiene, okay, even all the safety precautions. And most important is here, insurance. Mm-hmm. Every person is having very good health insurance. Yes, for the dental, it's like 70% they have dental insurance, but some people don't have dental insurance. So mostly they pay by cash. So it's good. It's good.
Okay. And ma'am, can you guide my viewers regarding DHA preparation? Like any institute or study material regarding any help?
I cleared my DHA exam in 2015. So that time, there was a very good book, Dento Gulf. And Dento Gulf is still there. So I was going through it and I found it really, really useful. And I was going through one more thing, e-dental portal, something that is also very good. And they are providing all the materials. But I would suggest not only focus on these materials, along with that, please read all the clinical books again and again. Because right now they are saying the pattern is easy. But some years they are tough also. Mm-hmm. So when I prepared, I literally prepared for NBD also. I prepared for ORE exams. I prepared for everything. And the questions literally came from everywhere. Mm-hmm. That's the thing. Mm-hmm. Yes. So master your clinical skills, master your clinical dentistry books. They are definitely going to help.
Okay.
Yes. I will just suggest you, like, definitely Dubai or UAE completely, it is expensive than India. If we compare, it is almost 3 to 4 times expensive than India. But when it comes to rent is definitely quite expensive. Okay. So initially, like even if you are taking a 1 BHK, I'm talking about the 1-bedroom kitchen, that also minimum, I'm talking about the minimum in Dubai area, it will come around 80,000 rupees monthly. Okay. Monthly. That's the thing.
The rent itself is 80,000 rupees. Oh,
yes, rent. I'm talking about a 1 BHK. Mm-hmm. But initially, sometimes what happened, the person used to come, like if anyone is coming in, they are getting less salary. So they used to take a one sharing basis. They used to live with the sharing basis. Mm-hmm. Number of apartments are available with that. So they used to manage. Food is quite cheaper here. And you can get a very, very good Indian food here. So that's not at all an issue. Mm-hmm. South Indian, North Indian, every kind of food is available. And that is pretty much cheap. That's the thing. If you want to live with a family of two, then your monthly expenses, if you are living in a 1 BHK like that, then monthly expenses, including, I'm talking about your rent, including your bills and everything, that will be around 7,000-8,000, you can say, dirhams. It means more than 1,60,000 like that.
Okay.
That much, yes. So expensive, yes. Definitely Dubai is expensive. So if you are married, I will suggest you, if you are coming, then please, husband and wife, if both are working, that is really good. Mm-hmm. And otherwise, if any senior is coming, then I think in dentistry, definitely with a seniority level, your salary is also more. But if I am talking about any freshly graduate or only 2 or 3 years of experience, then definitely they have to compromise a little bit on salary. Mm-hmm. But later on, it will be good.
Mm-hmm.
And wow. I must say, UAE is one of the safest country in the world,
mm-hmm.
especially for the ladies and mm-hmm. for kids, everyone. It is one of the safest country.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
You all can just follow my Instagram and LinkedIn account, which I guess we will put in the description box.
Yes, definitely, ma'am. Definitely. Yes. And I'm following ma'am's Instagram account daily. And guys, if you want to learn endo, if you want to see endo cases, then ma'am is really putting up daily good cases on Instagram. So do follow.